Right, I've just come for a car wash here in Chiang Mai, Thailand, and I thought it'd be a good opportunity to give an update on the truck. Right, I've come back to the apartment to film because it was just too loud at the car wash. So yeah, I'll give you a quick walk around of the truck and where we're at now. So yeah, I bought it about a year and a half since I bought this truck from north of Chiang Mai, and when I bought it, it was absolutely terrible.
Hey, what have I done? Oh no, I bought it. We're on our way to see a mechanic already because the steering's like awful, so. Yeah, see how we get on. Might not be able to film that much. Brakes aren't too good either, but it looks nice.
It was a danger on the road. I've never driven a car with so many handling problems and everything. God, it was awful. But fortunately, that led me to meet the guys at Retro North, and they sorted me out. Met Bon Diao and all the other like guys, and yeah. Became really good friends. They really helped me out with the truck, got us back on the road, and yeah, and me and Millie travelled all over north of Thailand. Had an absolutely great time, really good. Yeah, fast forward a bit of time, I had to go back to the UK, so I left it parked up, and it came back, and yeah, the sun had not been too kind to the paintwork. So yeah, painted that and repaired the paint. And yeah, and then once more back on the road. But unfortunately, over the last few months, it's not been the most reliable. Quite a few problems have reared their ugly faces. So yeah, I'll lift the bonnet and show you what's been happening. The issue with this engine and carb, and well, a lot of things on this truck, is the amount of miles it's done. It's only done 56,000 or so on the clocks, but I think that's nearer 500,000. It's had a very tough life. And I think that's common for a lot of trucks out in Thailand. They're not like parked up for 20 years. They're used a lot. So it leads to a lot of wear on the engine and carb and stuff. So some of the wear like we saw on the lifters and stuff was, yeah, crazy. I've replaced the head gasket again on it since last time, and it's still leaking a bit. I've tried a little bit of that liquid moly sealant, see if that helped, and it didn't really help. So that's still leaking, unfortunately. Just a little bit of water. It's not too bad, and it's not affecting the running at all. So yeah, we'll keep an eye on it. But yeah, and then I've replaced a lot of distributor parts as well, like new cap, points, rotor, lots of things on that, just to try and make it more reliable, because yeah, I had a lot of trouble with that as well, unfortunately. So but anyway, things are all running well now, which is great. Oh, I've replaced the battery as well. That's a new battery, loads of new dizzy parts, rebuilt the carb a few times with a service kit as well, and that's running better now, and then new fuel pump. So it's finally running okay, but it hasn't been the past few months, which has led us, unfortunately, not to travel as much. But it's been good to spend time in Chiang Mai. So that's everything under the in the engine bay. Been a few changes. Let me go inside, show you inside. So inside we've put in a new stereo system. So you'll see I've got speakers in the doors rather than the kick panel where they should be, and I've done that just because I think they sound better when they're in the door. A lot of people say it wrecks the looks, but I don't mind it, and yeah, I can get bigger speakers and better sound, and these are pretty knackered anyway, these door cards, so it didn't bother me that much doing that. And rather than put the stereo in the dash and spoil the looks of that, I've put the stereo under the seat, so you'll see it down there, and yeah, it sounds good. Sounds really good. I've also got like an undersea subwoofer to go in, so I'll be doing that shortly as well, just wiring that in. Yeah, and that should give us a bit more bass. It'll sound really good. But the main problem I'm having with the stereo is you can't always hear it because it's incredibly loud in here. Very loud. And so I've tried to put some sound deadening in various places, and that's helped a little bit. But yeah, the main problem is, I think, with the chassis mounts are perished. So all the vibrations come through the cab. So I've got a kit to replace them, but before I replace them, I've got to replace the mounting points. So you'll see down there, there's gaps in the floor and stuff, like the floor's knackered. I've got a replacement floor to go in, a new one, but yeah, it's just getting round to welding that in. So it'll probably have to wait till next time, but I've got that all ready to go, as well as all the frame bushings and stuff, so sort all that and it should be good. As well as that though, the exhaust is actually touching the cab, so that needs bending back down. I don't know, I must have hit a bump and not the exhaust, bent the exhaust. I have got the option of actually replacing the exhaust with a new one, which Bond says is about 3,000 baht, so not quite reasonable for a custom exhaust getting welded in. Yeah, 3,000 baht, but I've been thinking, and I'll head back to the engine bay and show you what I've been thinking. So I've been thinking, with all the problems I've been having with this engine, that it might be time for an upgrade, that I should maybe do an engine swap. So the little J15, it's all right. It's not got much power, but I think it's more than enough for Thailand. But it's just been bothering me, all the wear on this engine. Yeah, it's too much wear and too many problems. I want something a bit more reliable, especially if I'm traveling around. So I've been looking at engines and I'm thinking I might put an SR20 in, which will make it like a bit of a different beast. This, it'll be quite quick, a lot more power, and hopefully a lot more reliability. It'll be a tight fit, but yeah, I think they just fit in. Bond's got one at the garage now. Nice engine. The only problem with them is the wiring, because it's a 20-year-old engine and there's lots of sensors and stuff. So maybe I'll bring a standalone ECU from the UK and install one of them. So that's my thinking at the moment. Don't know what you guys think about that. I would like to keep this, but I just really want something a bit more reliable, and I might be flogging a dead horse trying to repair this, and it seems to just be one thing after another. It maybe is time to retire this engine. It's just possibly a bit too old. But before I did the engine though, I'd have to have a look at the suspension and brakes, because the problem I've been having recently is with the drum brakes. They're very say not temperamental, but yeah, they just don't work very good really. The drums on the rear are fine, but the front ones, they're constantly falling out of adjustment. Your brake suddenly and it'll pull to the left, or sometimes to the right. It's just all over the place for braking. And sometimes they stick on as well, and I've rebuilt them both, but they're still doing it. So yeah, that's a definite upgrade, is doing a disc conversion on this. Fortunately, it's not that complicated to do. I just replace the arms on this with those from a Datsun 720, and they have discs on and ball joints, so the steering should be a bit easier as well. So yeah, that's the plan. Gonna replace all the arms, put discs on the front, so I've got a bit more stopping. And then I'll think about doing the engine. Oh, and maybe replacing the suspension as well. New shocks. Oh, and also, if you look underneath, how it's sat at the moment is, it's pretty much sat on the bump stops at the height it's on, which won't be helping things. It does ride like it's on rails a bit, but that's because it is. It's, yeah, it's not, no, the suspension's not doing much. So I need to sort that out. And what I think I'll do, because I like the height of it, even though it's maybe not the most practical for Thailand, is look at maybe some drop spindles, and they'll allow me to raise the ride height, but keep the, well, keep the same ride height, but the suspension actually being active. So yeah, do that in combination with the discs, and I think we'll be sitting pretty. I think it'll solve a lot of problems and reduce the noise, and yeah, be good. So yeah, that's where we are now, and that's the future plans. I'm heading back to the UK now, and then yeah, in a few months we're back at it, and we'll get those upgrades done.